I text her an eggplant emoji. Yeah, I pull up my phone and we rolling. Yeah, I turn the street into V-Live. Yeah, jump off of the board and I deep dive.
What's good, y'all? It's your boy Ross back at it again with another video. And today, I'm going to be introducing y'all to my dog, Blondie. Now, let me make a disclaimer. First things first, my dog does have a cough. So, I'm already preparing myself for a whole bunch of jokes, mainly for my homies. If you've seen them in the comment section, you already know. They're the friends, they're the crew. They about to be making all the dog coughing jokes. You'll probably see some jokes saying, oh, my dog is my sister. Oh, hey, Ross sister. You know, the typical jokes that I get from them. So if you see that, just ignore it. Just know they're assholes. Hey, I already know y'all gonna say it. So it is what it is. But I'm about to introduce y'all to my dog. Now, this is Blondie. Blondie, say hello to everybody out there. I wish it would clear up. Why is it? Oh, there we go. What's good, Blondie? Yeah, this is the first time on the channel, you know what I'm saying? And I'm about to take her for a walk. It's been a little minute since she had some good exercise, so I'm gonna take her for a walk. She is a Lhasa Poo breed, and she has a cough, so you'll probably hear it in this video. I'm not sure if she's going to be coughing a lot when we're walking out there, but you'll probably hear it a couple times in this vid. Once again, to my asshole friends, fuck you guys. I already know what's coming. But yeah, about to take her for a walk, and we about to, you know what I'm saying, get some exercise in. Damn, get the sneeze. Oh, look at that. Hey, okay. Hey, you showing out for the camera, huh? Do it again. Not going to do it again. She's going to cough. Oh, Jesus, man. Hey, there we go. You almost did it. All right, come on. Let's go. Now, for those who don't know, Blondie is 12 years old. Come on. We've had her not all 12 years. I want to say we had her for maybe about, we got her in 2014. Yeah, around 2014, that's when we got her. And we got her from my uncle, actually. And he was actually getting, I guess you could say, evicted. And he didn't really have a place for her. So she was pretty much going to end up being a stray. And we took her in. Surprisingly, my mom, who was always, like, the biggest against having a dog or whatnot, decided that she wanted to, you know what I'm saying, take her in for a little bit. We actually were just gonna keep her for maybe like a week, and she was like, you know what, let's, you know, she decided to keep her long term. First night we got her, she was scared. Like, she actually, like when she got in our in the house or whatever, she actually used the restroom in the living room, and my mom was not having it at the time. So she was nervous. We put her in the backyard, and she stayed in, like, in the corner of our backyard the entire night. So we decided to, you know, leave her in the house because she's a house dog. She let us know she was a house dog real quick. So what she would do, say we would go to work. Well, we didn't leave her in our house at first. We would leave her in the backyard. That's what we would do. We would leave her in the backyard. And we found out that she was digging underneath the gate to get to the front yard. So every time we would come back home, she's in the front of the yard, in the front, waiting on us, like, what's good, my niggas? I'm like, god damn, like, she would just keep doing that. So we realized she was not an outside dog, and we was like, okay, cool, so she's not an outside dog, we're gonna go ahead and keep her inside, because we ain't have really no other choice. She was not having it at all. Not even the slightest. She was not about to sit up there and let us keep her outside. So that's what happened. And from there, she's just been a house dog pretty much the majority of the time. She's really struggling with me because she don't want to know what's, she don't want to stay on one side. Stay on one side, please. So, but yeah, that's pretty much the short story of Blondie, how we ended up getting her and how we kind of had to adjust to how she moves and operates. Because to be honest with you, she let us know very quickly, outside, no. Inside, it's where I'm at. Treat me like a goddamn queen. That's what it is. Come on. Now, I must say, this type of breed is actually really, like, trainable. Like, I want to say it was maybe that first incident where she used the restroom in the house. Granted, she was nervous. She was scared. Two or three times, she's actually used the restroom, like, in the house on accident. One of the times was we accidentally left her in the house for too long. Like, we didn't get, like, me and my mom, we didn't get home until, like, super late. So we left her in the house too long, and she was basically pretty much just holding it in, and she ended up using the restroom on herself. Well, using the restroom in the house. So we was like, okay, we know we have to, you know, kind of take her out in the mornings and in the afternoons when we get home. I think that was the one time we forgot to. So she's pretty good at not using the house as her personal toilet. Like, she's really good at that. Come here. No. She's really good at that. So she's highly trainable. Like I said, when we got her, she was at a decent age. So she was really socialized to people. She's not really socialized to other dogs. I've had to find that out, unfortunately. I would bring her around my homie's dog at the time, and she would just get really aggressive. So that was the one thing that I wish we were, you know, able to, like when we got her, like, she was more socialized with other dogs, but she wasn't. So that was just an unfortunate situation. Her hair is not, she doesn't really shed too much, but you definitely want to maintain it, because, you know, as dogs move around outside and stuff, they tend to get like stuff caught in their hair, and definitely you'll get matted. If you let it grow too long, you'll end up in a situation like we did, where her hair got so long at one point that it was like when she was used the restroom, some of the giblets would get caught, and that was the worst, you know, worst time trying to get that cleaned up. That was awful. So definitely grooming wise, you know, we've only had to get her groomed like maybe like once every month and a half, really, because her hair, her fur doesn't really grow back too much, like, not too fast. So that's really the one benefit of her, you know what I'm saying? She enjoying herself. I don't know if y'all can see her, but she enjoying herself, getting her little exercise in, you feel me? So that's one thing you have to be aware of. Definitely dogs like that, you definitely want to get them groomed, you know, depending on how fast their fur grow back, and also making sure they properly get washed. You know, we will wash her maybe once every 2 weeks or whatnot, because you, after a while, you can smell her when she coming into the crib or come into your room. You're like, hey, you smelling wild. So we're gonna have to wash you. But grooming wise, pretty easy. Sociable wise, it's really sociable when it comes to people. She's not really that aggressive, actually, at all. It's just other dogs she's pretty aggressive with. Easy to train. She listens pretty well. When I tell her to do something, she do it. You know, they're easy dogs to train. So if you're interested in getting a dog that you won't have to worry about getting too big, too rowdy, Lhasa Poo mix breed, those are the dogs you want to go with. Like, she's the easiest dog I've ever had. Granted, I haven't had that many dogs, but she's definitely the easiest one that I've had. Early 2018, like, it was noticeable, and then it just got kind of worse. I wouldn't say worse. It only comes up when like somebody comes home, and when she gets excited, oh, she's gonna be coughing up a storm for the most part. Like, right now, she's panting like normal. You haven't really heard too much coughing from her. Like, she's just walking normal. Everything seems fine. We've even taken her to the vet multiple times, and they said she's fine, healthy-wise. She's just a little bit overweight. But other than that, like, it's nothing to be worried about. So that's kind of what the situation is at this point with the coughing. Honestly, I think it's just she's just gotten older. And, you know, I'm not sure exactly. They don't even know exactly what's going on. They say it may have something to do with her heart. We're not sure. So, but for the meantime, all we can do is make sure she's eating good. Make sure. Come on. Come on. Come on. Anywho, we make sure she's eating good, give her the proper exercise that she needs, and you know, just keep her, you know, keep her comfortable, man. So it's pretty dope to be able to watch your dog grow over the years, and you know, and it's, I'm a dog person. I'm really a dog person. So like when it comes to coming home or whatnot and your dog greeting you with excitement every day, like us people, sometimes we take that for granted, you know what I'm saying? We take that for granted. So it's pretty dope to have that. And I'm definitely thankful for that. You feel me? So plus there's been a couple instances, like times where she'd be riding with me in the car, and they'd be like, oh my God, your dog is so cute. Oh, it's so adorable. I'm like, yeah, man, appreciate that. And I've gotten free food from it. You feel me? Just because my dog was adorable. I'm like, hey, man, appreciate that. So, benefits to having a dog. She's awesome. And I actually would highly suggest people check this breed out. Once again, it's Lhasa Poo Mix. I'm pretty sure I'm definitely probably pronouncing it wrong, but that's the breed. And she has the attention of the other dogs across the street. All right, so we made it back to the crib. My phone overheated, which caused the camera to cut off. So, you know, I had to cut it short. But, you know, she got her exercise in for the day, and we're just going to chill out. So, if y'all want to see more of Blondie in my vlogs, let me know. Comment down below. I appreciate all the love and support I've been getting so far on the channel. She appreciates it, too. All you guys that are commenting some asshole comments in the comment section, fuck you guys. I already know what's coming, but I appreciate y'all rocking with me so far, and more content coming this week. So I appreciate y'all kicking it with me. See y'all on the next one.